Greetings, one and all, to the most cursed, most cringiest corner of the internet. A YouTube channel content creator actively alienating everyone in both the analog and digital world. Well, welcome, good evening, wonderful dice of all alignments. I am Lunar. OBS Gen seems working just fine. Let's hop into this, shall we? Hey, I'm lost. Do you know the way to the surface? I think there's more than one way, but generally going up. Thank you. What's that glowy stuff? I'm not sure what it's called, but it gets really hot. I saw a squirrel jump in it once, and let's just say I won't be doing that anytime soon. Things you might didn't know. The center of the crystal area, there's a controller, but people haven't realized that the center is shaped like a cup. Somebody tells me I should write that down somewhere. But I'm definitely not going to. I have no idea how to work anything. See that door up there? Yeah. You can lock with the key, but it can be a bit tricky. Well, it's a tricky part. They always lock after you go through them. Oh. If you're not sure where a door leads, you might just want to be safe and have an extra key. Came here without an extra key. Yeah? Let's chalk this up as a lesson. Good thing I keep an extra key in here. What would happen if I tried to launch this in VR mode, even though I don't own a VR anything? Let's find out together. Could not initialize. Okay, that makes sense. Nope, that crashes it. Okay, I think I fixed it. Okay. idea when the last time I even played this was. I do actually have it on the PlayStation too, but I hardly ever play it like that. I'm sure this'll. Done a full Let's Play this game before. That was a couple years ago or something. Volume is so low. Can I adjust? No? I don't know, it's probably loud for you guys. Okay, I'm pretty sure I'm pushing those buttons. But okay. This is perhaps what happens when you play a higher difficulty game after a while not playing it and staying on. Probably can't actually do anything with this with the controller, but who knows. I have a trackpad. Okay. Controller seems to not really do anything. I don't know if this is like the default setting that you're supposed to come into when you start this up. What is this? Probably be a good idea if I should go find the mouse and everything and plug it in.
Well, at the very least, we're going to find out how intuitive things are. One Earth mass, Arthur. Earth weighs one Earth. I've watched a lot of Gray Still Plays videos. Music's nice. It's nothing super complicated, but this is pretty chill. Welcome to Lunar Just Spaces Out and Enjoys Music. The most fucked up thing ever. If I just sat here and did nothing and it just like Earth explodes, like what? I didn't even do anything. That's bright. Well, that was not intentional. I don't even know what's happening right now. Okay, this is the static electricity Earth that I am either adding or dragging. Is it actually having an interaction with the... Is it actually interacting with stuff? You know, I haven't actually placed it anywhere yet. don't think it's actually. Everyone would be dead and everything would have exploded if that were the case. Okay, in case we're, like, in case anybody's, like, kind of curious about what I'm trying to do here is that I'm trying to think of the closest I can put it. Like, here's the idea. I know I made a video. I kind of talked about some of this sort of stuff, but we're just me sort of spitballing bullshit. But I think it was called Descent or something, that game. But I'll probably put a link in the description or something to it. But the idea is I'm wanting to what's the closest I can put this to this to where they get a binary warping with each other and become binary stars. I don't want to put it so far away that they don't, but also I don't want to make them explode. Oh, there's an actual automatic binary button? That's no fun. Can I not turn it off? Okay. And there. Well. Huh. Earth. Where are you, buddy? Earth. At least Mars is coming along. You're okay with that, right, Mars? You're totally gonna be okay? And it's gonna slingshot it. So. And I know ideally the idea should be, what if we could make a second sun that's half the mass of the sun and then half the mass of the current sun. I mean, they're at least orbiting each other just in that direction. I mean, Jupiter's coming along. Where is Earth? What is this line? Is that Earth? Let's see. My maximum scroll out distance. Oh God. You know, when I imagine a binary star system, that's it's not how I expect it to be. I expect it to be a completely stable orbit. Instead, it goes around it and slingshots itself forward. I have made a slinky. How's that going for you? Seriously, where's Earth? I need to check to see if anyone's still alive on Earth. For sure, Earth somehow got completely... Of all the planets, Earth is the one that's completely just gone. I like the background, though. Cow. Well. What is happening here? Bye. I mean, does this count as solving the three body problem? I know that's complete fucking bullshit of me to say, but still. This is... the hell is happening? Still not sure where Earth is. You'd think the three suns would be enough to, you know, bring the planets back. But nope, I guess they have too much owl velocity. Wait, did I lose some? Okay, we have one that's completely... Why do I only have two? Did I somehow despawn one of them? So I get for getting easily distracted, like, hey! Oh, Venus is in the area. Well, we'll try to restart this, but before that... if I just build... Ah. Oh, something happened. Is there a search bar? So I can just type in what I want? Really? Oh, it's only got one letter E. We'll just put this here, try to bring everyone back. I don't know why nothing's... Do I... Is it because it's paused? Are we just that zoned out? Huh. That doesn't seem very healthy. Reset this. so how do I return to default? Start. We'll take it down to that point. We'll just check on Earth. Check on Earth. That's a concern. And it's going down. So we removed like 15% of the mass of the sun. I mean, everything's still maintaining the same orbit, as far as I can tell. Noticing a lot of things in the outer area are leaving. Well, Earth has become a snow globe, and everyone is dead. But we at least have just about the same. Okay, how did I average temperature is 7.3 Celsius. Climbing, because, you know, it's where we are in relation to the sun and everything, but still. We'll just reduce the mass just slightly. The tiniest bit of change we can. We'll see if that really made a difference. I only removed 1% of the sun. And yet, where's the mouse? Yeah, I only removed 1% of the mass of the sun. And yet the Earth is turning into a snow globe. I only removed 1% sun. How many people are alive? Max temperature, 12 degrees Celsius. Where's our sea level at? I don't know how to read that. Again, I only removed 1% of the star. And the Earth is turned into a snow globe. Pretty sure at this point everyone on the planet is already dead. I just don't know where to find the thing telling me. Sea level should be going down, right? And the rate at which it's getting colder is accelerating. What do you mean speed of light? For liquid. How you doing, Bars? How do I want to look at this in a different way? Negative 106 Celsius. I don't know if that's a big difference from Mars. All I know is that Earth is not doing the greatest. So 1% of the star being gone. Just 1%! Everyone's dead in like a... well... well, in that case, how's Venus doing? -420 degrees Celsius. So, we're a snow globe, you're still on fire. How is Mercury colder than Venus? Does Venus have more of an atmosphere than Mercury to hold in heat? I mean, it does have a lot more sulfur stuff. Besides, Mercury probably has a more drastic change from daylight to nighttime in terms of temperature. Probably have one side that's burning hot and the other side that's super cold. Wouldn't say you could live at the horizon between the two, but that would be moving probably faster than anything could ever move. Well, I mean, at least Earth's staying in its normal spot. Just negative 20 degrees Celsius. I don't know if there's a point which it just sort of decides it's not going to get any colder. By the way, did we lose any... I don't necessarily think we lost any of the outer planets or anything. Let's say we just double Jupiter. Everyone's like, what are we doing? I don't know. Well. Why do I feel like any time there would be a situation where there's a rapidly fluctuating number, if there was ever a planet that was... Oh yeah, tidally locked like our moon is. Anyway, Earth, are you getting warmer? Still getting colder, huh? Times 10. Gradually getting warmer. How's the rotation, everybody, doing? Or it could have just got to the point that it's at a stabilized temperature from the sun. At what point do you become a star? Okay. I can see the sun moving. Let's just see how that plays out. Still cold. So for the most part, our solar system is still pretty... We've lost 1% of the star, and we've multiplied Jupiter by 200 times. Or did I double it twice? So it's either 200... Or did I do 10 times? I think point. So everyone's orbit's pretty much the same. The only difference is the sun is moving in the direction of Jupiter, or at least trailing it. Looks like Earth and Venus are getting closer. Mars is... we're getting more of an elliptical. 2052. I mean, imagine everyone hadn't died of all the ice. I'm pretty sure this would be killing them. We turn the solar system into a spaceship. Mars, did you lose your moons? I mean, I don't know how you would possibly control. I mean, I guess if you were suddenly have the power to magnify the size of Jupiter, you could just do it at a certain angle to pull a star in a certain way. And technically, Earth is staying. In the correct orbit. Okay, Uranus is fine. Uranus is like, no the fuck I'm not. Hi, Pluto. I mean, if you're here, we must all be okay. Neptune. I'm sure this has many implications that are not something I know about. But for the most part, this is a stable... Okay, we are 19% of the sun. Double. And we'll just see how that works. Mars, are you okay? Pretty sure Mars is not okay. Where are you at, Saturn? Saturn. Saturn, get the fuck back over there. What are you doing leaving? I'm just gonna give you enough matter to mass to go back. Okay, you are less than a Jupiter. Okay. Now you're slightly bigger than what Jupiter is now. Saturn might be too far gone. How are you guys doing? Seems to be a pretty stable orbit. Hey, Jupiter. A little bit more, man. Saturn's kind of going its own way. Okay, any more and it'll explode. Okay, you're picking up some speed, Saturn. Let's make you a little smaller. Okay. Well. Okay, now you're half the sun. You have enough. Is this Jupiter next to it? Yes, it is. And they are... Jupiter. What is rotating around the sun? Venus and... I can't read that. Mercury. Well, that's just... I have no idea what you would even describe this as. Let's go ahead and Pluto, so you're like, hey, I'm included. Okay, Jupiter's over here. Got Saturn, get back in the line. Okay, double. Jupiter. Double. Jupiter might not be okay. Did you become a neutron star, Jupiter? Jupiter. Jupiter, are you okay? You're doing a thing. I'm trying to see where Earth is in all this. Go a few times. I've done a thing. I may have made a black hole. How did you bounce? Why are they bouncing? They're narrowly missing being slingshotted. That... Okay, I really doubt the structural integrity of any planet or star changing velocity that fast. Like, shouldn't Jupiter have just exploded? There's the sun? Mass of the galaxy. So... Hi, Pluto. There you go, Pluto. Is there any way to see the other galaxies? Let's restart this. My attempt at a thing may have ended poorly for everyone. I mean, Neptune's fine. I mean, as long as you live on Neptune, you're okay. Okay, so we're making a game of how many binary stars can I make before something explodes? Everyone's like, this is a horrible misuse of what this is meant to be. I'm like, yeah, at least Gray still plays version of this. Is more entertaining, he's all excited. I'm just like, what if I put this here? You know, at least this grid form. I don't know if it's... That have prevented it from... I mean, double the heat of the sun's is kind of making that hot. What if there's a way to, like, do both suns simultaneously? Like, select both so I can, like, have both their masses at the same time? Not that it matters, everyone's already dead. This point. Okay. Can I make a save like this? I don't know how to save. So... we're just going to hope we get it right on the first try. We'll try to put this in the middle. Pause. The computer's like, what do you mean you wanted to select both? Okay, so that's what you would do. You would... and we'll just see how this works. Explosion. Bye, Earth. Okay. Restart. Pause. Add. Still. Sun. What? That's not what I wanted to do. I deleted it? That's not what I wanted to do. Whatever, let's see what happens. Neat. Pause. How is this one astronomical unit? And this is one astronomical. I understand its perspective, but still. It's not how I would guess it from this angle. Apparently I'm doing terrible at reading where a decimal point is. So a tenth of an astronomical unit. Close enough. Okay, so I'm quadrupling how many stars there are at the center of our solar system, but each one has 1/4 the original mass. Go. Does it have reverse collisions? Do it like this. By the way, how you doing, Earth? Everyone's dead. Okay. Just checking. This does defeat the whole purpose of a multi-body problem. They're supposed to be equal in mass to each other. At the very least, I'm getting them to be near each other. Double your mass. We will pause this. Hey, Earth. Can I lock on to the Earth? Thank you. Where's the moon? See how many people are here. We're gonna have to do a solar smash for that. I don't know. add something? Nice if I can see where the moon was for reference. I don't remember how far away the moon is from the Earth. Okay, judging by proportion of size, let's say the moon would be this far away. And I'd say Titan's about the same size as the moon, as far as I can tell. I think I made another Titan. I can't see. Can I see what's happening? Why is Earth moving like that? Well, it's the slingshot force of a sudden moon. Nope, we're still around the sun. Okay, it's no longer a moon, it's just... it's definitely throwing off some orbits, it looks like. I imagine what would happen in this situation. Like, at first I thought Earth was going to slingshot out of the solar system. I thought the force of this, and again, why don't I see the moon? But I imagine what's going to happen is eventually either... because I know technically Jupiter pulls on the Earth a tiny bit, but in the same regard, when Jupiter's at a different part of the orbit, the Sun pulls on it more, so it balances itself out. But I think in the long run, what's going to happen is the Earth has a faster orbit around the Sun. So what I think is going to happen, provided Venus, Mars, and Jupiter don't affect Titan, I think Earth will eventually fully lap Titan, and on the way back around, will crash into it. Or at least alter the gravity, alter the orbit enough to where eventually after a few... now granted, this has only been a few years, actually. Speed it up. That is very close. Earth, can I... arrow. Is anything affecting... nope, everyone's fine. Slow that down a little bit because I can't tell what's happening. Music's really... it's nice. This is making me dizzy. There's probably something we saw earlier to say it's like stabilized motion or something. So that I don't get... or we just like... switch our view to be on the sun. Well, this seems pretty stable. Is everyone alive on Titan? I mean, everyone alive, I'm just saying. It is very cold there. It is not quite the mass of the Earth, so why don't we try to change that? It's probably as close as we're going to get to Earth without it possibly destroying the Earth. The average of temperature is getting hot. Nope. Okay. Radius. Oh. I did not see where that decimal point was correctly. Bit denser. We have 72% of the mass of the Earth. But we're technically bigger and twice as dense. Was trying to get it to orbit the Earth. Everyone, Earth is fine. Ish. Yeah, they're fine. I mean, it's not a snow globe, right? And I haven't actually done anything to the Earth. Aside from put something else kind of really close to its orbit. It's cold, but I mean, a certain person in Florida would have a yeah. Where's life likelihood? Can I add something? Pause. Earth. Just trying to copy paste. Okay, so we can remember that. Obviously, this changes the total mass because I'm just adding shit. So it's not really balancing anything out. And go. It would probably take a while to figure out, okay, what things can we add to Titan that would make it have life? Kind of surprised that Titan and Earth have a... Let us see if anything explodes ever. Everybody's fine. Mercury is like, why am I in two places at once? I don't think the scale is showing accurately, but that's fine. Hey Earth, how's it going? Huh. You're a snow globe for some reason. I haven't done anything to you, other than the fact that it's a little over 400 years in the future. Though we did also have it going where it said like 1,500 years per second, and I don't know, I assume maybe there was just some limitation to the way it works. I mean, unless we're like a different part of a Lankovich cycle. At what point did the Earth freeze? I don't know. But this guy really didn't do much to change anything. Yeah, let's change that. 10 times the mass. Not affecting anybody, huh? I wonder if you would be able to see this very well from the Earth. By the way, notice that it seems that Titan is the one lapping Earth now. It is a lot heavier now, though. There we go. Earth is okay. So Titan blew up. Everybody just fine. Hello? Kind of cold. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, just turn up the air conditioning, I guess. Okay, about the same mass as the sun. Pluto, hi, Mars. Thank you. There, the Earth didn't have to be by itself. Imagine statistics of people playing this game. They're like, yeah, everyone who plays this game just destroys the universe. But then again, it's really the only things you can do in this that have a noticeable change that object. Thank you. There's a game called Blue Fire. It's kind of like Brave Fencer Musashi. Played some of it way back when. It also has a side game called Blue Fire Voidmaker, which is a custom. We're going to hop right back into that and see how that feels. Whenever it refinishes re-downloading. I don't remember how to play anything. Beginner's Challenge. For someone who hasn't played it in like who knows how long. Jump. Fireball, shield. Okay. I was hoping I could run one side of the wall.
Yeah.
Missed a couple. Well, at least now you have a chance to get those things again. Here we are on our last hit point. Why did that hurt me? I don't understand why that... I mean, at least we... I don't understand why... Nope, didn't quite do it, but... You guys saw what I was trying to do. Like I said, this is a level where people made custom levels. So you can see there's the featured ones made by the person who made the actual game Blue Fire. Which Blue Fire is its own separate game with a story, and it's you're intended to play through all of the original Blue Fire game before doing this, and I never finished that game. And I tried to tie it into this, and then I was like, okay, I'm good. Newest. Well, those aren't graded very well. Yeah, we'll stick with whatever the best rated ones are. I said the main game has a lot more combat in it. But this one being just a custom level, it's more just focus on. I don't have a double jump. Do I need a double jump? Assuming that electricity hurts me in this situation. There's probably a reward for doing this without... Oh. They just ran around? Is this really... Oh. I'm sorry. Okay, so you can't get back. There being some again, this is probably meant to be played by somebody who's actually beaten the whole game multiple times. And probably played about 100 other people's custom modes. Thing. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to hold the button longer or just tap it. What's ideal for? Can I get up to that? Not at all. And that's the other thing, there's those things in the middle, which means what you're wanting me to do is just go straight across. You're wanting me to jump. Thank you. really sure what caused that fire. Eliza, that's blue fire void maker. There's also another game called Straight Up Blue Fire. Let's try to install that real quick. Go to our home, we'll uninstall Void Maker while we're waiting. But yeah, Void Maker is the like Mario Maker sort of thing. And just normal Blue Fire is the normal game with the story and stuff. But I'll probably play a little bit. It definitely reminds me a bit of Brave Fencer Musashi as well as Spyro the Dragon. I suppose I could read more of the Book of Aegeron thing. Okay, I already read that part. Koth. Fragment of a drunken conversation in Robber's Cove. It's rude to stare. I jest, sir. I can see you are impressed. Is she not a marvel to behold? And do those curves not make the heart beat faster? She's a thing of beauty. Is she not? Her price is steep, but I can assure you that you will not be disappointed. For she has a reputation to behold. She is a sorceress of the wind, the fastest ship to sail the southern seas. And she will safe you to any point. She can take you across the Amber Sea, and can outpace any ship on Reaver's Run. She will brave the winter storms of Neversea or steal to the harbor of Bones, but no, she will not take you to Koth. No, Koth is a cruel mistress. I would sooner sail the dark waters of Styx. Koth is an ancient place, her dark foreboding jungles choked with twisted vines. Their sharp leaves flow with a poisoned sap, the color of blood. I have skirted 1,000 miles of her coasts and never once seen a port. Landing on her shores is nigh impossible. Below the surface lurk jagged rocks that tide and time can't smooth. Their razor edge are the bane of any ship, and only the smallest of watercraft is able to attempt to approach. Fool's Harbor can be found all along her northern coast. Their locations marked by once proud masts jutting from the water, haggard and at unusual angles, were lying broken, tangled, and twisted in their writing along the rocky shore. The rocks rise, giving way to giant trees that cover the entire land, smothering all beneath. These are no ordinary trees, for each one could yield the lumber to build a ship of fleets. Some say there is no life beyond her rocky shores, but I have seen it, or at least evidence of it. Several times I've passed as close to the shore as I dare, and I have seen one of those great trees crash to the ground, the splitting of its trunk, a thunderous roar, setting of a cacophony of cries for miles around, animal or human, it's hard to discern. On occasion, when winter's grip extends to her northern shores, enough foliage falls from the trees to allow a glimpse beneath the canopy. I have seen colossal buildings in there, but I cannot say what they were. I have seen the flickering of lights as I passed by, and I've heard the distinctive chink of steel on stone. I have, of course, heard rumors, tales that tell of darker things that I've seen with my own eyes. I have spoken to a few who claim to have been there, a ship's captain I've dealt with, aristocracy and peasants, soldiers and pirates,
merchants and beggars, and I have learned to tell the truth from a lie. And so I believe what I was told holds a fair measure of the truth. Koth's people are wild in appearance, their skin scarred and their eyes bright. They are led by powerful sorcerer kings and warrior priests who worship dark gods and prolong their lives by drinking the blood of those they deem unworthy of their society. They are a secretive people, hostile to outsiders, and of those that venture there, few return, fewer still with their sanity intact. Koth's people have a natural affinity with the beasts of that wild land. They use sorcery fueled by blood sacrifice to bond with them, using them as beasts of burden or riding them to war. Now you know the truth. You ask yourself why anyone would go to Koth. Well, my friend, the answer to that question is a simple one. There are no defiled in Koth, which then begs the question why. Some speculate there are no gates in Koth, but I have seen them on her shores. No, the answer is they were never opened, or the sorcerer kings know their secrets and have kept them closed. Is the answer for that secret not worth dying for?
We're not going to make any progress in this, but at least we already had a refresher on how to do anything. But more than likely, I probably stopped because I was either lost, or couldn't finish a puzzle, or couldn't complete a jump. I do say that this game is good and it controls really well. Has an RPG system much like Zelda. Yeah, this game has a really cool soundtrack. It actually kind of looks like I'm sitting there.